NAT can be very useful to us, but it can also cause problems. Think about a case like this. An application needs to send traffic from one host to another. This particular app puts the source IP address in the packet's payload. The host also puts the source IP in the packet's header. When the packet passes through a router configured with NAT, the source IP address in the IP header is changed. Notice though, that the IP in the payload doesn't change. When the packet arrives, the receiving application sees that the IP in the header is different to the payload, which causes problems for this particular application. Perhaps it thinks that this data has been tampered with. This has been a generic example, of course, but there are definitely applications out there that do break when NAT is applied. You may have guessed that one application that doesn't like NAT is IPSec. IPSec offers message integrity, which means that it verifies that packets haven't been tampered with or altered while in transit. At a high level, IPSec uses IKE, or Internet Key Exchange, to build the initial security tunnel. When the tunnel has been built, IPSec uses ESP, or encapsulating security payload, to encrypt the contents of the traffic in the tunnel. NAT tampers with the packet by changing the source IP in IKE's IP header. NAT does not change anything in the payload, of course, so this means that the source IP in the initial IKE packets won't match the source IP in the ESP packets. IPSec sees this as a security threat and it will drop the traffic. We could turn NAT off completely, of course, but usually that's not an option. So instead, we're going to look at NAT Traversal as a solution. NAT Traversal, or NAT-T, is a method of getting these applications and protocols working across NAT. We're just focusing on how it works with IPSec in this video. It's really not too complicated. IKE will use UDP on port 500. ESP uses protocol 50, which means it's not using TCP or UDP, it's an independent protocol. NAT-T takes the entire packet and wraps it in UDP using port 4500. This is important to know if you're troubleshooting. If you see UDP port 500 in your logs, then you're not using NAT-T. If you see port 4500, then you are using NAT-T. When the traffic is forwarded through a router that applies NAT, only the outside headers are modified. The original headers are left intact. A NAT-T aware device at the other end will remove the outside headers and process the IPSec traffic as normal. See, told you it wasn't too complicated. I hope this has helped you in some way, so let me know what you thought in the comments below.